Hello everybody, Terry back again with another video, and today's video guys is going to be about talking about yesterday matches, Tsitsipas, Medvedev, Zverev, the so-called next gen, or we cannot call them next gen anymore, but maybe now gen. Yeah, call it what you want guys. They are through to the quarterfinals, all three of them, Zverev, Tsitsipas and Medvedev. After pretty convincingly victories for three of them, guys, they were never in trouble. Let's start with Tsitsipas first. He looked really furious out there. He looked so impressive. PCB, my dark horse. Now all of my dark horses are out. I had four of them: Rude, PCB, RBA, and Roger Federer. Three of them lost with dignity, and one of them he bailed out. Tsitsipas, he was in cruise control from the first point to the last point. PCB, all respect to PCB, but he doesn't have any weapons, man. He is solid. He's consistent from a baseline. He doesn't have a big serve. He doesn't have a big return. He doesn't have the biggest weapon, the biggest forehand of the tour, not the biggest backhand. He just gave Tsitsipas all time in the world for Tsitsipas to execute his game plan. And what is Tsitsipas' game plan? To hit as many forehands as possible, which he did. Do you know how many times in percentage that Tsitsipas hit his forehand after serve? Do you know? I'm gonna tell you guys. 78% of the time when Tsitsipas landed his serve, he was hitting a forehand. So the second shot from Tsitsipas' racket after hitting a serve was a forehand. 78% of the time. And if Tsitsipas hits this many forehands, 78%, which he did against PCB yesterday, he will be really difficult beating, guys. He will be really difficult beating, and he won his straight sets 6-3, 6-2, 7-5. The only time this match actually was a little excited to watch was the third set, where PCB broke Tsitsipas' serve for the first time in the match. And it was just little excitement in the air, only the third set, but not more than so, to be quite honest. Tsitsipas in the end won the third set 7-5. All in all, Tsitsipas, he lands 66% first serves in, wins 75% behind those first serves in, which is great number. You know what I said, over 70% is always great. And he wins 59% behind second serve. So he was dominant, both in winning points behind first serves and second serves. Because when you are dominant winning points behind first serve and second serve, that means that you have been the winner in all the rally battle. Both the short rally battle, both the middle rally battle, and the long rally battle. And that's why he was so dominant in the serve points won, both behind first serves and second serves. Stefan Tsitsipas. In the end, Tsitsipas, he fires 41 winners and only 17 Anforosteros. He does 24 more winners than Anforosteros. Impressive stuff. And does 6 aces and 0 double faults. If you look at the PCB's numbers, he lands 73% first serves in. That is quite high number of first serves in, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how many first serves in you land, even though it is crazy high like it was in PCB's case here. If you don't do damage on your serve plus points, it doesn't matter. It is not just landing your first serve. You need to do damage after you have landing it. After you have landed your first serves. And that was not the case with PCB. He was winning only 62% behind this first serves in. Only 62% compared with Tsitsipas, 75%. And winning points behind second serves, PCB was winning only 43%. Compared with Tsitsipas, who was winning 59%. Tsitsipas break serve, 5 out of 12 break match opportunity, which is a great number. PCB break serve only one time out of 6 break point opportunities. So PCB was not the most effective player out there yesterday. And PCB, he did 32 unforced errors and 29 winners, so he does 3 more unforced errors than winners. Tsitsipas through to the quarterfinal, and he will face there his nemesis. I should call that Medvedev is his nemesis, is his kryptonite. Or what do you think? 1-6 in the head-to-head for Medvedev's favor. So Medvedev is leading 6-1 in the head-to-head against Tsitsipas. And Medvedev, he came through really impressive. Like I predicted, I had Medvedev as my quarterfinal candidate when the tournament started. But when I saw him just cruising the draw and just finding his groove, finding his range, finding his serve, finding his spots, finding his consistency level, finding his shot tolerance, and most important of all, being motivated, because he has not been that crazy motivated in playing clay court events before the French Open started. We know that, guys. He has said that. I hate playing on this surface. He has not had that mindset during this French Open. His mindset has been so positive. He has wanted to win matches, and he has won 4 of them and dropped only one set in the second round against Tommy Paul. And against Christian Garin, a clay court specialist who has won all of his 5 titles on clay, he was superior, Medvedev. Won in straight sets. 6-2, 6-1, 7-5. Didn't give Christian Garin one single chance. Medvedev was superior, was landing, did 14 aces, six double faults. Little too many double faults in my opinion, but 14 aces is a really great number. Medvedev, there you have a great example in Medvedev. He didn't land crazy many first serves in, only 56% first serves in, so he was not even over 60, but he won 86% behind his first serves in. 86! He didn't give Christian Garin a chance to breathe when Medvedev was landing his first serves. Even though it was not crazy high number of landing first serves in, he won 86% behind those first serves in when Medvedev was landing them. Why? Because he didn't give Christian Garin one single chance. One single chance. Medvedev is a wall from a baseline. And when he pushes that wall button, it is not easy hitting through Daniel Medvedev. I don't care which surface, hard court, grass, or clay. Like the case is with Medvedev, clay is his worst surface. I'm sorry. So, Medvedev wins 86% behind first serves in, wins, and he did a good job winning points behind second serves as well. 53% winning second serves. It is always great stuff when you win over 50% behind second serves. And did 46 winners. Medvedev fired 46 winners. And we say many times, Medvedev cannot finish off points on clay. He damn did that yesterday. He could finish off points yesterday with 46 winners and 32 unforced errors. So he does 14 more winners than unforced errors than Medvedev. Compare that with Christian Garin. Christian Garin, he landed 64% first serves in. He landed more first serves in than Medvedev. Medvedev lands 56, Christian Garin landed 64. But doesn't matter. Christian Garin wins only 56% behind first serves. Only 56. Why? Because he couldn't hit through Medvedev. He didn't do a great job from 1 to 4 shots, which Medvedev did. Christian Garin was not superior in serve plus points, which Medvedev was. And that's why Christian Garin wins only 56% behind first serves in, and only 42% behind in second serves. Only 42%. And if you look at Christian Garin's winners, he does only 11 winners, my dear God, only 11 winners and 29 unforced errors. So Christian Garin does 18 more unforced errors than winners. What about that, guys? What about that? Only 11 winners. I don't know, man, when I saw last time a tennis player doing only 11 winners in a 5-set match. This was not in 5 sets, it was a 5-set format, of course, but this match was over in 3 sets. And Christian Garin does only 11 winners and 29 unforced errors, so he does 18 more unforced errors than winners. That shows what kind of a wall Medvedev was. And Medvedev break serve, I don't know how many, six or seven times, Medvedev, 8 times I believe Medvedev break serve, yeah, 8 out of 11 break push opportunities or something like that. seven or eight times Medvedev break serve. And Christian Garin break serve only once. Christian Garin, he only saw two break punch opportunities. Only two. And the only time Christian Garin's break Medvedev serve was in the third set. And this match was exactly like Tsitsipas match. The only time this match was little excited to watch was the fifth set when Christian Garin break Medvedev serve for the... Not fifth set, I'm sorry, I'm talking too fast and too much. The third set, I mean, when Christian Garin break Medvedev serve for the first time in the match and only time. But it was no problem. Medvedev came back and break back and break again and won the third set 7-5 after doing tremendous good of two last games in the fifth, in the third set with superior running inside forehands. I don't know if I've ever seen Medvedev doing that kind of a great superior running inside forehands, and Medvedev comes through in straight sets and plays the quarterfinal against Stefan Tsitsipas. Yeah, the Russian bear against the super talented Greek. That will be a tough match to call, guys. That will be a tough match to call. I have not decided yet who I will pick there. I had Tsitsipas coming to the final before the event started. But I didn't think that Medvedev will be in this quarterfinal, to be quite honest, when I did my preview 10 days ago. And now Medvedev is in the quarterfinal. And the head-to-head is 6-1 to Daniel Medvedev. Tsitsipas doesn't like Daniel Medvedev's flat strokes. They don't bounce that very high, but they do that on clay. But at least they bounce more on clay than they do on hard court and grass. But they still doesn't bounce extremely high. They will not. Tsitsipas will not have easy time finish points off when he faces Daniel Medvedev because he has those flat strokes. He doesn't have that much net clearance, Daniel Medvedev. So it is not easy doing a lot of winners against Daniel Medvedev. So let's just ask Christian Garin, who did only 11 winners against Daniel Medvedev. So it will be a tough one to call that one, that match, that quarterfinal between Tsitsipas and Medvedev. I have to think about that. And let's see which of these two players I will pick when I do my quarterfinal predictions. When we have all the quarterfinal matches set up. We have two now. Medvedev against Tsitsipas and the second one, Zverev versus David Vetchkovina. Zverev was in cruise control. He was never in trouble in this match. I don't know if I've ever seen Nishikori this week like it was yesterday. Nishikori is wasted. He's over. He's done. Nishikori, the quarterfinal specialist who has played so many quarterfinals in slams, he is done. All credit to Nishikori. He has had a decent career, but he will not be a quarterfinal and semifinal Grand Slam contender. For a Grand Slam title contender, he will never be, and has never been in the past either. But he used to play a lot of quarterfinal Grand Slams in the past, but he will not do that anymore, at least not in my opinion. At least maybe one quarterfinal Grand Slam appearance he has still left in him, but even that, I'm doubtful, guys. I really am doubtful. So, Zverev came through 6-4, 6-1, 6-1. The only set that was a little excited was the first set where Tsitsipas was a break up, I believe, in the first set. Zverev breaks Nishikori serve eight times, I believe. Eight or nine times, something like that. A lot of times. And Medvedev, he breaks serve. Now I remember, Medvedev break serve 6 out of 11 break match opportunities. So Medvedev break serve 6 times against Christian Garin. Not 7 or 8 times, like I said in the beginning of the video. 6 out of 11 break punch opportunities Medvedev took yesterday. And Zverev, he break 8 out of 11 break punch opportunities, Zverev. So he crushed Nishikori's serve. Nishikori has a really weak serve. He didn't do one single ace yesterday. Zverev, he landed 71% first serve scene. He won 68% behind first serve scene and won 68% behind second serve. So Zverev was winning as many points both behind first serves and second serves. 68%. Nishikori, he landed 60% first serve scene and was winning 40% behind his first serves. Only 40%. That is horrible. AI actually was winning more points behind second serves, 49% behind second serves, which is strange. You should never win more points behind second serve than first point, at least in my opinion. But Nishikori did that. He won more points behind second serves than first serves. And Nishikori landed only 16 winners. He fired only 16 winners and did 36 unforced errors. So Nishikori does 20 more unforced errors than winners. How in hell will you stand a chance then? I have never seen Nishikori this flat like it was yesterday. It was not like Zverev was superior. He was good, Zverev. Good. Not more. He was Zverev was for sure not as good as Medvedev was against Christian Garin, and for sure not as good as Tsitsipas was against PCB. Zverev landed 26 unforced errors and 25 winners, so Zverev does one more unforced error than winner. So it was not like Zverev was superior by any means, at least not in my opinion. He was decent, and this between decent and good. This was all about Nishikori. He was horrible. I have never seen Nishikori this weak like it was yesterday. Never. Never. It has to do with Zverev as well, because Zverev made life difficult for him, but it also has to do with Nishikori. He was so flat. He did a decent first set, Nishikori, but on the second and third set, Nishikori was already in Japan, guys. He was already in Japan! In a flight in Japan! Alright, guys. So we have Zverev, Tsitsipas, Medvedev through to the quarterfinals. Tsitsipas and Medvedev will battle out who will play the semifinal. That will be a tough one to call, a really tough one. And Zverev and then Zverev will face David Svokina. He has a 2-love head-to-head. Zverev against David Svokina. Zverev is a big favorite against David Svokina. I will be surprised if David Svokina takes out Zverev, even though David Svokina, he really is a shot maker. He can really kill the ball, guys. He really can hit a lot of winners, which he did against Delbonis, where he won in 4 sets. Even though that David Svokina actually did more unforced errors than winners against Delbonis, but he still was the much better player and won in 4 sets. But I just can't see David Svokina. He has done a great run. We was not expecting David Svokina to go to the quarterfinal, even though that David Svokina is a really good clay court player. He has done some really decent clay court runs in this clay court season. We all expect, at least I expected, that the team will be in this quarterfinal spot and face Zverev. But we all know what happened to team. He lost in the first round. And then when team lost, many of us believed, oh, now that team has lost, this will open up the draw for Casper Ruud. Casper Ruud is a really good clay court player and has done a really good clay court season so far. He won a title in Geneva and has defeated one of the best clay court players in the world this year. And the player I'm talking about is Stefanos Tsitsipas, whom he defeated earlier this year, Casper Ruud. But he cracked. He lost also, I believe, in the third round, Casper Ruud, against David Svokina, against the player who will face Alexander Sasha Zverev in the quarterfinal. So, no, David Svokina is a surprise to many of us. Will he continue to surprise and defeat Zverev even in that quarterfinal? It is not impossible. It is Alexander Sasha Zverev, after all, the double fault specialist of the ATP Tour. Even though he didn't do that many double faults against Nishikori, he did only 2 double faults, I believe. No, I think that David Svokina's journey ends now. I think that Zverev will be too heavy. He is a much better player than David Svokina. He has a much better serve. He has much better returns than David Svokina. He's solid on the baseline, Zverev. Zverev has become consistent. These new gens are starting to become more and more consistent. They are not losing early like they used to do, say, a couple of years ago. Look at Tsitsipas, he's become consistent. Look at Medvedev, who has also become consistent. He was in the final at Australian Open, Medvedev. Now he's in the first quarterfinal here at French Open, Daniil Medvedev. Zverev has played. This will be Zverev's third quarterfinal appearance at French Open. He has lost 2 of them in the past. One against Thiem, one against Novak Djokovic. Now Zverev has his chance of his life to play his first ever French Open semifinal in his career. And I don't think that Zverev will let this this huge opportunity out of his hands. So I think Zverev will make it to that semifinal and face Medvedev or Tsitsipas. Let's see who of those two that Zverev will face. All right, guys, let's see. It will come a quarterfinal prediction video. I don't know when. Maybe later tonight or maybe tomorrow. Let's see when I have time because I am on my way to work now. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe. See you next time. Peace.